While there's a ton of information out there on how to get started with AI, there is very little information on how to become an AI product manager. So here's three books that I use to transition from a developer to a product manager to an AI product manager. Inspired by Marty Kagan is definitely a starting point for anyone who wants to become a tech product manager. As a product manager myself, I do use this book very regularly, both for building great products as well as mentoring new product managers joining my team. The book is divided into three main parts: the right people, the right product, and the right process. Part one deals with what kind of roles you'll have to interact with as a product manager, what you expect them to do, and what they'll expect you to do as a PM. While these roles are slightly different for every company, the overall product management org structure is applicable for most companies that I know of. Part two addresses the importance of great vision leading to great strategy, which leads to great team objectives, which eventually leads to building a great product. The OKR technique helps to keep the team on track and focused on the right goal. Part 3 explains the four main risks of why a product would fail and how you can avoid them. The book contains real-life problems faced by product managers in Netflix, Apple, Google, and how they use these approaches to solve them. It helps us remember and apply these techniques in our daily work whenever we face these problems. Book 2 is the AI Product Manager's Handbook. This book is divided into three parts: AI basics and terminologies, building an AI product from scratch, or integrating AI into an existing non-AI product. Part 1 covers most of the basic AI concepts like machine learning, deep learning, the difference between them, types of machine learning, even AI deployment strategies like AI ops. Part 2 covers building an AI team and an AI product by managing the data and ensuring performance and security and different product standards. Part 3 explains why you don't really need to start from scratch every time. You can identify the most valuable functionality which you can integrate AI into in your existing product. Make sure to read chapter 6 in part 2, Understanding the AI Native Product. It covers the four phases of AI product development and what members do you need in an ideal AI dream team. And finally, book 3 is Product Management for AI. This is comparatively a much smaller book, only about 60 pages, but it's an excellent place to get started. Tech books published by O'Reilly are known to be simplistic and to the point. You can even get this book for free as a part of a free trial on O'Reilly website. This book has 4 chapters. Chapter 1 gets you up to speed to basics of AI product. Chapter 2 goes a little more into details about how you ideate, build, and deploy an AI product. It also explains what minimum data management skills you need as a product. Chapter 3 details how you bring an AI product to the market and what role you play in this as an AI product manager. Releasing the product is not the end game. And that's why chapter 4 details how to debug an AI product which is launched, how to continuously monitor it and improve it so that the customers continuously get the benefit of the AI. But it's important to note that these three books will set you up to become a good AI PM, but not a Gen AI PM. The difference is that until 2022, companies had to build their own AI models to add AI functionality into their existing features, which is obviously much more complex and takes much more time. But ever since ChatGPT was introduced in early 2023, companies started producing their own underlying platforms. For example, Microsoft had Azure AI, Google had Vertex AI, and now Amazon has SageMaker. So you as a company can use these underlying platforms and the AI SDKs that they provide to add AI to enhance your existing functionalities. So while these three books help you to become a good AI PM, you don't really need to worry about all of this to get started. You can use libraries like Vercel and LangChain to quickly build prototypes for your customer, identify the real problem that exists, and then test it out before you actually try to build your entire AI model. Comment GenAI PM below if you want a more detailed video on how to use Vercel or LangChain to set up a quick prototype. For everyone who commented on my previous video, thank you, and do subscribe to my newsletter where I plan to send more detailed emails on my experience with the Azure AI certification. And if you haven't seen it yet, go check it out. By the way, don't forget to subscribe.